Hello, this is my second C++ tutorial, and in this tutorial I want to talk to you about data types, OK and variables. OK, let's start the program the similar way as we do in the last lessons. So, include IOStream and int main with no parameter. So this is already a data type, the int. It is called integer. It's a whole number. Okay. What is a variable and how to declare and define it? Okay, a variable is a space in your memory, RAM, RAM, and you store something in there. It depends what data types are using. For example, case of so in this tutorial I want to introduce you to the most often used data types in C++. It is called built-in data types because it's originally built in the language, although later you can make your own data types, and we will. Okay. So, what the data types is bool. It stands for boolean. It's 1 or 0, so true or false. That is just that two states. So, bool b. It's good to have a easily notifiable name for your variable. B is an easily notifiable for bool. Later we will use the complete words for that. So for example, boolean is good, but it's too long for now. Okay, you shouldn't call variables you shouldn't give such a name to a variable that is a keyword in the language. So for example, bool will not be good for us. Okay, so bool b, and the variable should start with the English alphabet, one of the letter from the English alphabet, or a line like that. It shouldn't actually, it mustn't start with a number because the compiler will give an error. So we call it b as we did. Okay, this variable is declared, but it is not defined. It contains 1 or 0. It's randomly. Why? Because the memory is actually a big storage. It contains a lot of 1 or 0, and sometimes when a program don't use that memory, then the value stays there. So your computer will not erase bit by bit to bit everything in the memory which is not used. So in an earlier program may use that memory, but it is exited and it is not used anymore. Okay, and I want to introduce you, there is a way to declare more variable in one line. So put the data types and the name of the variable. This name you can refer it later, and with a comma you put another variable name. This is of course the same type, so it is a boolean, but in this case one bool is enough for us. Then define the variable, so give true or false, 0 or 1, it is not matter which you use. So 0 is same that false, it's not matter. Okay, then declare a character char variable. char c, and you can define it in the same line where you declare it. So char c equals, I don't know, a character a. You have to put the simple quotation mark there, because if you don't, it would mean that you want the c to be equal the variable a. So because we don't have variable a, it will give an error, of course. So put a simple quotation mark like that. The c variable is now the contains the a, actually the key code for a, but if we write out, we will get the character a. Now a very commonly used data type is int, integer, a whole number. It is the same as the return type of main. The main will return that number to the operating system, indicate that there is an error or not. So for example, int I equals 42. This is of course the answer to everything. By the way, you may notice that we use one equal sign, not two, or because if we would two, that is true or false. So it is mean, is it equal? It is one, then it means let it be equal to 42. In case of 42, we don't use not double quotation mark, not simple quotation mark, just simple the number. Okay, and we want to declare a float f and declare a double d. So there is a way to make f equals d, f equal and that equals to something. For example, f equals d equals 3.14, like that. So it work like d equals 3.14 and then f equals d. Your compiler will work that way. Both float and double can store float numbers, so not whole numbers. Double has much precise, it can store much greater numbers. Okay, and I think we write out the most important variables. If there is a variable later, I will talk about that. For example, long. And there is a way, a modifier that you can write before the data type, like unsigned. It means there is no minus number, so it could contain the same amount of number, but without the negative, it can contain much greater positive numbers. Okay, I will talk that. I think there is nothing else, but if later it comes something that I don't talk, I will try to define and talk about that then. Okay, actually if you type this, as you can see, if you write out a lot of things, that it could be very annoying to write std colon colon always. So because I know that I am just using the IO stream header file, and everything inside IO stream is in the standard namespace, I could do that right here, using namespace std. It will result that everything is searched in the standard namespace, so we don't have to write std colon colon always. So write out the b variable, which is boolean, should be write out 0, make a space there, write out the variable c, this will result an a character, make a space, write out I, this will give the answer to everything, and write out f, a space, and d, and a new line. So f and d should be the same, 3.14, I should be 42, c should be a character a, and b should be 0, and there is a new line after it, and because it's a good practice and a good habit, return with value 0, indicate that we have no error. Okay, save it and get a terminal from somewhere, and I am the right directory now, so I can compile it. g++ first.cpp, like that, and the output file there is second. Okay, it gives no error, great. Now we can run the program second, like that. It gives us what we expected exactly. So this is the most important data types. I think the assignment operator, so the equal sign, is clear for you how to use it, although I made a tutorial about operators and I try to explain a lot of operator there. Okay, and I think that's it for that tutorial. Thanks for watching and have a great day.